It began in March 2009. The Red River of the North was approaching record levels at Fargo. The National Guard was called in to bolster protective measures along the banks of the river near downtown. Bulldozers and helicopters were employed to reinforce levees, and hundreds of volunteers showed up to assist their neighbors by creating citizen sandbag lines. But community leaders were genuinely worried about those protective measures being insufficient to prevent a catastrophe in downtown Fargo. Concerns were high enough that government officials requested on-site support from the National Weather Service in a manner that was unprecedented outside of a major hurricane event. In total, 8 emergency operations centers were staffed at one time, 4 of which maintained continuous operation for over a month. In the aftermath of this disaster, it became evident that the growing nationwide demand for this type of on-site support to high-impact events could quickly exceed the capacity of the National Weather Service IMET program. For example, in 2010, the year following the record-setting Fargo flood, NWS staffing was requested to provide on-site support for flooding in the Missouri and Lower Ohio River basins, for the Enbridge oil spill in Michigan, and for the Deepwater Horizon catastrophe in the northern Gulf of Mexico. These events underscored the need to develop training designed to build capacity for long-duration deployment to Emergency Operations Centers, or EOCs. Then came the spring of 2011. First, there was the horrific tornado outbreak of April 27th, the costliest tornado outbreak on record and the deadliest in a single day since 1925. With 324 lives lost. Just 25 days later, on May 22nd, a tornado rated as EF5 struck the city of Joplin, Missouri, resulting in 158 more fatalities and a swath of catastrophic damage extending 22 miles in length and almost a mile wide. The shocking nature of these events heightened awareness of our nation's increasing vulnerability to environmental disasters, along with the escalating costs of community resilience to such events. These facts, coupled with the increasing demand for long-term deployment to support both search and rescue operations and restoration efforts, tipped the scales toward a sense of urgency to build practical on-site deployment training for a cadre of forecasters not affiliated with the IMET program. That summer, the services chief of the National Weather Service Central Region secured support from his director to create a prototype training experience that would arm forecasters with the knowledge and expertise necessary to provide effective support in the ICS environment of an EOC. This is the origin of what is now known as IDSS Deployment Bootcamp. The first edition of IDSS Deployment Bootcamp was held in Kansas City in September of 2011. From the start, it was important to developers to make the training practical, realistic, and experiential. The original course format was a combination of instruction, group problem-solving discussions, and application-based exercises, culminating in a full-day functional simulation that incorporated 4 separate incident scenarios. Exercises were facilitated by a variety of subject matter experts, including National Weather Service personnel with deployment experience and EM partners certified in various incident roles. For example, the first course incorporated the planning section chief and the communication unit leader from the Joplin Tornado Recovery Operation, as well as representatives from FEMA Region 7 and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Response to this initial effort was very positive. Within a few short months, spread primarily through word of mouth, laudatory comments about this experimental DSS training experience reached the National Weather Service director. The director approved funding for the newly formed Operations Proving Ground to refine the content and continue offering workshops annually. The first major revision to the course was to focus the full-day simulation on a single incident. Synchronizing support for 4 events simultaneously turned out to be unmanageable. After the 2012 edition, the OPG director and instructors from the National Weather Service Training Center partnered to map out a plan for reducing the teaching elements of the course in order to add more hands-on exercises and collaborative problem-solving drills. As a result of this effort, subsequent versions were more interactive. However, it became apparent that some of the foundational teaching would need to be recorded and made available online as prerequisite material before the course could be truly transformed into a genuine flipped classroom format. Beginning in 2014, the OPG began taking on more R2O projects, with a full slate of experiments and training activities scheduled on behalf of the GOES-R program. This prompted a concerted effort to transition management of IDSS deployment bootcamp over to the National Weather Service Training Center as a formal, recurring training course. From 2015 to 2017, the National Weather Service Chief Learning Officer invested significant resources into producing the IDSS Professional Development Series. Publication of the first three professional competency units eliminated the need for any of the basic instructional components to be included in IDSS bootcamp. This opened the door for a complete revision of the course into a full week of exercises and immersive simulations. This revamped version is arguably the most intense and comprehensively experiential training course that the NWS has ever created. It's not uncommon for participants to say it's the best training experience they've ever had. IDSS Deployment Bootcamp has proven itself to be a highly desired and extremely effective training experience. It was created to serve an immediate need that arose from a rapidly growing demand for on-site support. It has now become a formalized, recurring training course, the capstone experience for those who desire to provide on-site expertise to risk management decision makers at disaster incidents or planned large venue events. In fact, in an email referring to the course, the Assistant Secretary of Commerce for Oceans and Atmosphere stated that the National Weather Service has set the gold standard for training for the entire agency. We've come a long way since 2009. And while we still have work to do before we reach our ultimate goal, IDSS Deployment Bootcamp has proven itself to be an important milestone on that journey, one that continues to be an invaluable component for preparing today's forecasters to serve tomorrow's weather-ready nation.